total cost in dollars to produce Q units of a good is given by the function C of Q equals 20.5 Q plus 84,000. Part A, what is the total cost to produce 800 units? So for part A, they're telling us that Q equals 800. We want to find C of Q, which is the total cost. So C of 800 would be equal to 20.5 times 800 plus 84,000. Which is equal to 100,400. Which means the total cost to produce 800 units is $100,400. For part B, what is the cost of the 800 first item? So to find the cost of just the 800 first item, we'll find the total cost of 801 items and then subtract the total cost of 800 items. This is often called the marginal cost at Q equals 800, which is the cost of producing the next item when Q is equal to 800. So again, we'll take the total cost of 801 items and subtract the total cost of 800 items. So when Q is equal to 801, we'd have 20.5 times 801 plus 84,000. And then when Q is 800, which we found above, we'd have 20.5 times 800 plus 84,000. We found C of 800 above, that's 100,400. And now we'll find C of 801 on the calculator. Which is 100,420.5. Giving us a difference of 20.5, which means the cost of the 800 first item is $20.50. There's a couple things I do want to mention about this. Notice how the cost function is linear, where 20.5 would be the slope of the linear equation. So as Q increases by 1, notice how the cost increases by 20.5, or by $20.50. And what we'll find is that we often approximate the marginal cost, or this value here, by evaluating the derivative of the total cost function at Q equals 800. If we look at our cost function for a moment, notice the derivative of the cost function, or C prime of Q, would be equal to the derivative of 20.5 Q, which is just 20.5, plus the derivative of 84,000, which would be 0. So notice for any value of Q, the marginal cost, or the cost of the next item, would just be 20.5, or $20.50. So the marginal cost using the derivative function and the marginal cost using the change of the total cost functions will not always be the same. But often C prime of Q, the derivative of the total cost function, is used to approximate the marginal cost. I hope you found this helpful.